Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let's just glorify the Lord. Let's just lift him up. Let's just say, Father, you are worthy to be praised. You are worthy to be glorified. You are worthy of all honor. You are worthy of all power. You are worthy of all praise. Let us revere the Holy Spirit at this time. Let us welcome his power. Let us welcome his presence. Holy Spirit, you are welcome in this place. Come and take over. Come and do your will amongst us. We revere you. Oh, the Father in heaven sent his Son. And the Son said, it is expedient that I go, so that the Spirit of God, the anointing, the oil, will come and be amongst you. And the Holy Spirit is the reason why the disciples tarried and waited to receive power. We welcome you, the power of God today. We welcome you, the power of God today. Come and give us strength. Oh, come and give us energy. Come and give us motivation at such a time as this. We welcome you, precious Holy Spirit. Just raise your voice and give him due reverence. Raise your voice and give him due honor. Raise your voice and let him take his place. We are those virgins that have decided to take the oil. We will not put our trust in any man. We have the oil and he is supplement for men. So today, welcome the Holy Spirit. Oh, usher in the oil. Smear yourself with this divine lubricant, the divine moisturizer that preserves you and continues to give you energy. Oh, receive the oil tonight. Even before we begin to pray, receive the oil, because we are still praying around doors, and this time we are praying around doors with the oil. Receive the oil in your house, in your room, in your bedroom. Before we go on to pray, welcome to the Miracle Center Cathedral. This is our overnight. We are about to make petition. We are about to pray. And after I am done, Pastor Robert Kayanja will come in. He will also usher us into a time of miracles, of signs, of wonders. But right now we are about to pray. If you are in the diaspora, wake up somebody. Remember, the oil is multiplied by a giving away. And the more oil you pour, the more oil you receive. I expect you in these few minutes to pour out by waking someone up, by calling someone online and telling them to tune in. Oh, come on someone. We are about to pray. Wake up someone in the diaspora. Or tune on your TV. Tell your neighbor to tune in. Tell them it is time to go and pray. It is time to petition. It is time to smear ourselves with divine oil. He says, in the last days I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh. The oil is no longer a one man show. We are operating in a dispensation and an era where the anointing of God has been availed to everyone. It is flowing from the pulpit to the congregation. It is flowing from the congregation to the community. It is flowing from the community to the nation. Oh, it is like that oil on the beard of Aaron. It is coming down. Come on, somebody, receive the oil tonight. Like I said, the oil is available in this dispensation and this era. Anyone can be anointed. In the last days, I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh. Not some people. Not some important few. Not the set apart few. But all flesh. Your sons and your daughters will prophesy. Or somebody in somebody's house, the children are getting ready to prophesy. Your babies are getting ready to prophesy. Yes, yes, yes. Your young men will see visions. Somebody's son will see a vision tonight. Although we haven't yet gotten into the word, I expect you to be touching your son's head right now and saying, my son, you will see a vision tonight. Let me declare it on my own son, Robert Jr., you will see a vision tonight. That is the dispensation we are living in. That's the era we are living in. Nobody has a monopoly over the oil. No one has a monopoly over the anointing. Everyone can be anointed right now. Oh, yes. Your old men will dream dreams. Declare it upon your parents. I declare it on my father. May he dream a dream. I declare it on my husband. May he dream a dream. Your old men will dream dreams. Oh, come on, somebody. No one has a monopoly over the anointing. But tonight, let the whole house receive the oil. Oh, as we gather tonight, Tracy Gwambe, I can see you. Owori Joseph, I'm excited. Jedida, I cannot wait. Tracy Gambe, I can see you. Kelly Martha, I can see you. She's such a Ruth. I can see you. Oh, Chris Opio, I'm looking for you. Evelyn, I'm looking for you. Irene, I have seen you. Charlotte, I am looking for you. Oh, yes. Zion Love, I'm looking for you. France, I have seen you, and I'm happy to see you. Yes, we are about to smear the oil around ourselves right now. Oh, somebody get ready. We are going to pray in the spirit. Call somebody, wake up somebody, tell them it is time to travail. It is time to pray. It is a deep shallow. Finally, I can see you. I am happy to see you. Oh, yes, Chiemba Bweswery. Those are my intercessors. You are welcome. Chirabo Justin, I can see you. Agatha Katrina, Akia Dorothy, I can see you. Irene, I'm excited to see you. Sarah Apio, I can see you. Jackie, I am looking for you. I cannot see you. Jennifer Mboa, I can see you. Alen Helen, I can see you. Atusime, I can see you. Hadija Naviria, you are welcome. Jennifer Mboa, you are welcome. The oil, the oil, the oil. Your house is receiving the oil. Oh, yes. Everyone is receiving the oil. Come on, receive the oil even before we go into prayer. The prayer today is about the oil. So you might as well receive the oil. Zion Love, finally, I can see you. Sarah Apio, I can see you. Cynthia Dexter, I can see you. Oh, Chris, I am waiting for you. Jackie, I am waiting for you. I am waiting for you. Kobugabe Lillian, I can see you.
Yes, Lord.
Oh, you are welcome tonight. And everyone watching us by way of television, you are highly welcome. We are still praying around doors and around the oil. The only difference between the foolish virgins and the wise virgins was the oil. So the oil affects the mental state. Depending on the anointing upon your life, you can either be wise or you can be foolish. Hallelujah. Did somebody hear that? Depending on the anointing on your life, you can either be foolish or you can be wise. The only difference between the foolish virgins and the wise virgins was the oil. And they were pronounced wise or foolish by virtue of who had the oil. And tonight we are going to pray that the Spirit of God will transform our mindset, that we will operate like those who are wise. We will operate in a manner that warrants for us to be wise. Our minds will make wise choices. Our soul will be led to cause our mind to make wise choices because of the oil, because of the anointing. The oil affects the mind. In
1
Corinthians chapter 2 verse 10, we see that the spirit can search out the deep things of God. And once you have the Holy Spirit and you know the deep things of God, you begin to operate as one who is wise and not foolish. And many people have been considered intelligent and they have no manner of academic criterion. They are not extraordinarily achieved in any way, but because they have made spiritual decisions, they have appeared wise.
1
Corinthians 2 verse 10 says, but it was to us that God revealed these things by His Spirit. For His Spirit searches out all things, and these things are shown to us. These are the secret things of God. And to us, these things have been revealed to us by God, by His Spirit. But we know that there are some people, because the Bible says, but unto us. But that shows that there are some people that remain in the darkness because those things have not been revealed to them by the Spirit, because they do not have Him. And so they operate like those who are foolish. They operate like those who are not wise. They do not make the right decisions. But Romans chapter 8 verse 4 says, for those who are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God. And I want you to know that every time that you are led by the Spirit, your representation is obvious. People look at you and they know you cannot be anybody's son. You are not just operating from a human point of view. You may have a physical background, but when you make spiritual decisions, people also realize that you have a spiritual background, spiritual parenting, and a spiritual father, and that is why you become a son of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And today we are going to start by looking a little bit into the book of John. And we know that John the Revelator was an exilee. And he had been exiled on an island called Patmos. Now there is one thing about being an exilee in a place where there are people, where there are buildings, where there is interaction. That is good for your mental state. And some of us who grew up in exile, you know, we know very well that because we were children, we were not affected, because we were in a state of interaction. But John, the Revelator, is exiled in a place where there are no people. That is enough to affect your mental state. When you have been taken away from people, when you are locked up, when you have no one to interact with,
the way so many people are right now, you have no friends to talk to, you have no familiar face to see. That is where John the Revelator is. But he remains steadfast. And in the first chapter, in the 10th verse, he says, but I was in the spirit on the day of our Lord. I was locked up, yes, but I was in the spirit. I was persecuted, yes, but I was in the spirit. I was imprisoned, yes, oh, but I was in the spirit. I was going through a tough time, yes, but I was in the spirit. Oh, come on, somebody. Amen. Is somebody relating to that? The devil did not foresee that John the Revelator's imprisonment was more for the glory of God than for vindication by man. The devil did not foresee that this time of isolation is more for the glory of God, because like John the Revelator, you were isolated, but tonight you are in the spirit. Like John the Revelator, you have been put away, but tonight you are in the spirit. Like John the Revelator, you have been forgotten somewhere, but tonight you are in the spirit. Come on, somebody, say to yourself, I'm in the spirit. Persecuted, but in the spirit. I may be frightened, but in the spirit. They may have intimidated me, but I am in the spirit. I am in the spirit. And regardless of what it seems like today, this day is the day of our Lord. And because he's in the spirit, John the Revelator changes his prison to a place of visitation. I want you to know that tonight your living room is changing. Your lobby is changing. It is no longer a small prison. It is no longer a small place of isolation. It is no longer what is separating you from your family. It is no longer what is separating you from your place of employment. Oh, come on, somebody. It is a time of the spirit. It is a time of visitation. It is a time for God to talk to you. The spirit of God changes John's mindset, and instead of feeling like a prisoner, he begins to feel like one who is being visited. Instead of feeling like someone who is locked up, he begins to feel like someone who is being embraced. Instead of feeling like someone who has been forgotten, he begins to feel like someone who has been remembered. Oh, tonight, may you feel remembered, Jackie. May you feel remembered, Zion. May your mindset change. You are in the spirit on the day of our Lord. You are in the spirit on the day of our Lord. I decree and declare a change of mindset. Depression is leaving you today. You are in the spirit. We are about to discover the secrets of God, the things that he communicated to John. If this time had not come, you would never have spent time with him. He would never have revealed to you all the things that he's about to reveal to you tonight. It is the same thing with John. He had a wonderful time on this island of imprisonment. The Lord opened out the secrets. Come on, someone say, I'm in the spirit. My children are in the spirit. My husband is in the spirit. We welcome the spirit of God. My mindset has changed. I am looking into heaven. I may not be able to look into the cities. I may not be able to see what is happening in town. I may not be looking into a restaurant, but the heavens are opening. I am seeing what is coming out of heaven. I am seeing what may be coming out of hell. I am looking prophetically. I am in the spirit on this island of lockup. I am in the spirit on this island of forgottenness. I am in the spirit on this island where I have been abandoned. I am in the spirit on this island where I have been locked up. I may not see people, but God is about to show me what will happen to people. He will show me what will happen to my family. He will show me what will happen in my country. Oh, come on, somebody. We are about to see it. Tonight we are going into the visitation of John the Revelator. Somebody declare, I am in the spirit on this day of our Lord. It's not a day of persecution. It's not a day of murder. It's not a day of imprisonment. Come on, declare it. It is the day of our Lord, because he has ordained it to meet you and talk to you. It is the day of our Lord, because he has ordained it to visit you and chasten you. It is the day of our Lord, because he has ordained it to reveal the hidden things. It is the day of our Lord. Oh, come on, somebody. It is the day of our Lord. It is the day of our Lord to unravel the mysteries of our God. The devil didn't foresee it. The devil thought that if John the Revelator was put away, they could crush his spirit. But he was in the spirit on the day of our Lord, even in his imprisonment. Welcome to the spiritual arena. Kezabu Rachel, you are welcome. Jennifer Mboa, you are welcome. Akia Dorothy, you are welcome. Abigail, you are welcome. Welcome to the spiritual arena. We are in the spirit on the day of our Lord. I decree and declare a spiritual atmosphere in your house now. A spiritual mindset. Do not look at yourself as isolated. Look at yourself as encompassed. You are encompassed with the angels in glory. Do not look at yourself as abandoned. You are being met by the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. You are in the spirit on the day of our Lord. That is no longer an island of imprisonment. Your house now is an arena of revelation. Your house now is a place of visitation. Your house now, oh, come on, somebody, is an altar where God is about to talk to you. Oh, you are in the spirit on the day of our Lord. You are in the spirit, and today is his day. It is the day of our Lord. So the depression is leaving. The anger is leaving. The worry is leaving. God has ordained this island, this time of corona, is our Patmos. Except that we will not die, we will be visited. We will have revelations. We will speak to God. We will see our Father. We will see our Father in heaven. Oh, come on, somebody. God has ordained this time for his glory, for his power. Say somebody. Oh, yes. I was in the spirit on the day of our Lord. Somebody claim the oil. Get into the spirit tonight. Even as we begin to pray, may the atmosphere in your room change. May the atmosphere in your house change. From imprisonment to an open heaven. Oh, from abandonment to visitation. May it change right now. May you begin to see what you have never seen before. Hallelujah. The visitation is happening right now. In Revelation chapter 21, verse 10, still in Patmos. Oh, John the Revelator says the Lord carried him away in the spirit to a great high mountain and showed him the Holy Spirit, Jerusalem, coming out of heaven. The Lord carries him Oh, he imprisoned, but the Lord is carrying him to a great altitude. Revelation chapter 21 verse 10. Oh, to a great altitude, to a great mountain, and he shows him the Holy Spirit, holy city Jerusalem, coming out of heaven. He says it is the Spirit of God, the Spirit that he was in, carries him to a great high mountain. The ones who have just joined us, we are praying from Revelations. Now we have gone to Revelation 21 verse 10. And he carried me away in the Spirit to a great high mountain and showed me the holy city, Jerusalem, coming out of heaven. You know, there are some things that you cannot see until you are at a greater altitude, because the higher the altitude, the broader the vision, and the lower attitude that we have been operating on. You look at the city and you see it is empty. You go to the restaurant and you see that the things are expensive. That is a lower altitude. Oh, but what happened to John the Revelator is that in the Spirit, God lifted him to a higher altitude so that his vision would be uninterrupted by the interruptions of the earth, by the things that worry us, by the physical concern. God lifted him and took him to the high altitude, to a high mountain. Do you know that that is the place of the church? Do you know that that is where you are supposed to be? You are a city on the top of the hill that cannot be hidden. Isaiah chapter 2 verse 2 says, in the last days the mountain of the Lord's temple will be established as the highest mountain. In the last days the mountain of the Lord's temple will be established as the highest mountain. I want you to know, child of God, that the Holy Spirit at this time is lifting you above, taking you to the level of revelation on which you are supposed to operate. You are a city on top of the hill that cannot be hidden, but you have been operating on lower levels where they could hide you. But right now I want you to know that these are the last days, and the mountain of the house of the Lord will be established as the highest mountain. You are about to be the most visible mountain regarding wisdom in your family. You are about to be the most visible mountain regarding revelation in your community. May God lift you up tonight to a high level, to operate at a high level of revelation, to operate at a high level of wisdom, to go back to the place where the church is supposed to be. People are going to come to you for advice. People are going to come to you for proclamation. People are about to come to you. God is raising you up above all the other mountains. You are becoming the city on the top of the hill that cannot be hidden anymore. God spoke to John the Revelator and he said, this is what I am doing for the church at this time. They are becoming that city on top of the hill. They are becoming the highest mountain that is being established. Oh, come on somebody, come on somebody, begin to pray right now. There is an establishment going on in the final days. The church is returning to the place that it was called to be, a position that has been lifted up, not for pride, oh, but for because of the fear of God. The fear of God will return to man. People will have nowhere to run to but to you, because because of the Spirit, people will have nowhere to run to, but to you for revelation. People will have nowhere to run to, but to you to be advised. People will have nowhere to run to, but to you to be blessed. Oh, come on, somebody, yes. Say, I am that city on the top of the hill that cannot be hidden. And God has prepared this time. He's lifting you up. Even as you pray, He's lifting you up. By way of revelation, He's lifting you up. Even as you hear the word, He's lifting you up. Oh, God took John the Revelator and He took him on top of the highest mountain. Oh, come on, somebody. May God lift you up tonight to take you. Oh, Jacqueline, may God lift you and take you on top of the highest mountain. That church has been despised for too long. That church has been put down for too long. That church has been left us for too long. But I want you to know that in the last days, oh, the mountain of the Lord's temple will be established as the highest mountain. Somebody say, I am the highest mountain tonight. In my workplace, in my family, in my country. Oh, come on, somebody. You, the Spirit of the Lord, does not take you backward. He brings you forward. The Spirit of the Lord does not take you to obscurity. He brings you into relevance. The Spirit of the Lord does not leave you behind. He brings you to the front. There is a time of relevance coming. There is a time of significance coming to those who are born again. This is the time for you to prepare yourself. Prepare yourself. Oh, get into the word. Listen to season summons. Oh, come on, somebody, pray powerful prayers. You are walking into dominion. God has anointed you to usher people into the final day, into the final hour. The church has to return to its place. In the last days, the mountain of the Lord's temple will be established as the highest mountain. Oh, come on, somebody. Everybody's attention has been withdrawn from what they used to consider important. There are people who used to consider sports very important. The sports auditoriums were full. Some people were into entertainment. Oh, some people were into drinking. But focus has returned to the body of Christ. And therefore, right now, God is showing John the Revelator. He says, you think you are persecuted. You think you are in prison. You think you are isolated. I want you to raise your eyes away from this. John the Revelator, this is who you are. You belong to the highest mountain. You are being prepared. John the Revelator, write me a book. John the Revelator, sing me a song. I know that there is a John the Revelator watching, and right now you are hidden away, but there is something that you can do. There is a place that you can enter. There is a place that you can hide. There is a revelation that you can receive. God is going to use you and me at this time. The church has returned to its original place. The Spirit of God will not leave you the same way He found him. If He can take David from the shepherds, from the sheep, and usher him into the palace, if He can take Saul from looking for donkeys and take him to governing a nation, I want you to know that you are being established as the highest man mountain. God is taking you from obscurity and bringing the church back to relevance. Get ready. Begin to pray. Get ready. Begin to seek Him. Get ready. Begin to repent. Get ready. Begin to ask Him to talk to you. This is the time when God will use you. You think that is His isolation, but God is showing you that you were above these people and you needed time to know that you were above. So prepare. You are coming to a place where you are moving to the place that the church was ordained to be. You are that city on the top of the hill. Nelly Martha, you are that city. Monica, you are that city. Chiemba, you are that city. Yes. Olivia, you are that city. Ronald, you are that city. Daphne, you are that city. Kobu Sinjo, you are that city. Annette Sefu, you are that city. Oh, he carried John the Revelator. In other words, John, don't despise yourself. You are in prison, but look above that. You are not that level. You are isolated, but look above that. Position yourself and treat yourself the way you are. Today, may every spirit of low self-esteem be diminished and broken in the name of Jesus. Everyone who has despised themselves, everyone who has looked down upon themselves, everyone who has laughed at themselves, I decree and declare, you are now being established on the highest mountain. You are the Lord's temple. Oh, you don't even imagine where you are going. Don't begin to think that this imprisonment defines you. You are above it. You are above it. Don't even think that this isolation defines you. You are above it. Oh, you are just being established. It may look like imprisonment, but it is establishment. God is using this period to lift you up spiritually. Oh, I see promotions. Oh, I see spiritual levels coming up. I see words of exaltation, being born in dreams and visions. Oh, come on somebody today. May God give you a dream of you being on the city of the top of the hill. Divine revelation tonight. Divine revelation tonight. In the mighty name of Jesus. Visibility. Oh, you cannot be hidden. You cannot be hidden anymore. If Joshua came from the back to the front and he was not even a Levite, but just because of the Spirit, John says, he carried me in the Spirit and he took me to a high mountain. The Bible says the mountains surround Jerusalem. Therefore, you must be on a high mountain to see what is in Jerusalem. God is not lifting you up for you to brag about it. God is not lifting you up for you to show off about it. God is not lifting you up for you to exploit it. God is lifting you up so that you will be able to live prophetically. When the Spirit of the Lord carried John, he says in his own words, and he carried me away in the Spirit to a great high mountain and showed me the holy city Jerusalem coming coming out of heaven, it is at this time, the time of lockup, the time of imprisonment, when God is going to show you what is coming out of heaven. The people on earth will not see these things until they are on earth. But you are locked up as a John the Revelator, and the heavens are opening up to you. You are going to see it as it comes out, and you will be able to tell the world, I saw it and it is coming. I saw it and it is coming. John the Revelator said he was lifted to a high spiritual level where the church is going, and he saw the holy city Jerusalem coming out of heaven. Tonight I declare an open heaven for you, so the eyes will see what God is orchestrating, what he is about to send down. May somebody see a cure of corona tonight. May someone see a vaccine tonight. May someone see your future ministry tonight. Oh, may someone who has seen lost hope, may someone who has lost hope see the heavens open. Oh, and hope coming down to you. May someone who thinks they are about to die see their future husband. May the heavens open so that you can see what is coming ahead. John the Revelator said the heavens opened, and I saw Jerusalem coming out from heaven. May you see your husband, your future husband, coming out from heaven. May you see your future house coming out from heaven. May you see your future building coming out from heaven. May you see your future ministry. It is difficult to discourage a spirit-filled person, because the Spirit of the Lord leads us to the future. We can never be discouraged about our children. We can never be discouraged about our marriages. We can never be discouraged about our ministries. The heavens open and we see what God is bringing down. The people on earth wait until those things come to the earth. That is when they see them. But we can see what God has for us. We can see the plans he has for us. Plans to bring us prosperity and not disaster. Plans to bring us the future that we hope for. Oh, God lifted John in this time of imprisonment, and he saw what was coming from heaven, and it was beautiful. It was a holy city. Can somebody tonight stand on a higher level? May the heavens open so that you can see what is coming. My brother, it is beautiful. My sister, it is beautiful. Oh, it is glorious. It is glorious. May you be able to see it. May you never be discouraged. May you never feel like you're in prison. This is a time of revelation. The heavens opened, and John the Revelator saw the city coming out. Even before it was there, he could see the church tomorrow. He could see the faithful tomorrow. He could see you one day. Hey, come on, somebody. Pray in this isolation. Open the heavens so that I may peep and see exactly what is happening. Open the heavens so that I may peep and see what God has prepared for me. Open the heavens, Lord, so that I may peep and see. Show me the hidden treasures of darkness, the hidden wealth of secret places. Oh Lord, open it. Reveal to me the deep things of God as you take me to a higher level. Oh, the heavens opened, and John the Baptist was able to see the Holy Spirit. Somebody tonight is seeing the future. You, as God, has allowed you to peep and see the things that I have not not seen, eyes have not seen, that ears have not heard. Come on, someone, the great and mighty things that he has not revealed to anyone. May God allow you to peep into heaven to see your future baby. May God allow you to peep into heaven. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. May God allow you to peep into heaven and see your future wedding. May God allow you to peep into heaven. That is what the Spirit of the Lord does. And he carried me away in the Spirit. Revelation 21:10, he carried me away in the Spirit. And he put me on a great high mountain and showed me the holy city in Jerusalem coming out of heaven. May God allow you to peep into it. May God allow you to peep into it. God can allow you to peep into it. God can allow you to see it so that your hope is refrained. Come on, somebody. May God allow you to peep into it. To encourage you. This is a time of isolation, but God can encourage you by opening up the heavens. I remember when I was believing God for children, I didn't even have my son, and after some time, after I had been praying and fasting, I was in my room and I woke up. And I was in the middle, I was in between sleep and waking up. And those of you who have had a vision will know exactly what it is. And I saw the door open. And I saw two baby girls fighting for a ball. The Lord was allowing me to peep into heaven. And I said, oh my God, there are two girls. They look like they are in the same age group. I didn't understand this. I said, are these twins? But I got pregnant shortly after that. And I had a son. So I forgot about it. I said, I think that was the imagination of my mind, because this is a son. They are not even girls. It's not even girls. But when I had twins, I remembered that the Lord was allowing me to peep into it so that I would get out of depression. So that I would get out of discouragement. So that I would get out of crying. Oh, come on, someone. May you be allowed to peep into heaven today. So you will see what is coming. So you will see what is coming. That deep things of God. That deep things of God. That is what the Spirit does. He shows you what has been shown to him. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Oh, thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. We are still praying around the mindset. We are still praying around the mindset. This is a time when the Spirit of God has to change your mindset. And today we are praying that God will lift you up where you belong. That the Spirit of God will take you to the highest mountain. Like he did John the Revelator. Galatians chapter 5 verse 18 says, but if you are led by the Spirit, you are not longer under the law. Because the law of the land may say so many things. The law of the land may stipulate that only the educated will be lifted up. The law of the land may indicate that only the beautiful will be significant and relevant. But to John the Revelator, God showed that it is the church. To Isaiah, God showed that it was his temple that was going to be lifted up above every other mountain. It was being being filled with the Spirit of God, it was about being filled with the anointing, that you will be raised like John the Revelator, that you will be brought up like John the Revelator. Oh, come on, someone, take the raising up. There will be a prophetic unction because of the peeping in. People will begin to prophesy. The prophecies of the final day will not happen by mistake. People will peep in and they will say things that have happened, and that is what exactly has happened. We have seen everywhere on social media people who prophesied correctly about this virus, from Zimbabwe, from the United States, from different places in the world, from the United Kingdom. They peeped into heaven and they saw it. We are about to operate in the days of the like in the days of the apostles, where we will walk into homes and be welcomed, not because we are known, but because of the oil. Somebody say, I welcome that in the mighty name of Jesus. I welcome that in the mighty name of Jesus. Prophecies will be steered by the Spirit of God. There will no longer be imaginations. They will be peepings in to a higher level, to a higher arena. Oh, come on, somebody.
Amen.
Prophetic unctionings of what is going to happen and what is the solution to what is going to happen. So keep your ears open right now. That is what will be happening. The church is returning to its place in the last days. The mountain of the house of the Lord shall be exalted and established as the highest mountain. As the highest mountain. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Revelation chapter 17 verse 3. And he carried me away in the spirit. This is still John the Revelator. Into a wilderness. And I saw a woman sitting on a scarlet beast, full of blasphemous names, having 7 heads and 10 horns. A woman
Omukazi
is supposed to represent the church.
It's
supposed to represent the bride of Christ. But this time, John the Revelator, God shows him a woman actually represents, like I said, the body of Christ, the bride of Christ, an ecclesiastical system. Ecclesiastical gama an ecclesiastical system.
Yes, embere yekanise obuwerezi.
And but this ecclesiastical system is being pushed and given energy by a beast. And the other thing that God is doing to our mindsets in this time is that he is positioning us and pushing us into a place where we will have divine discernment and judgment. Not everything that glitters is gold. So John the Baptist sees a woman who represents the church, but unfortunately the woman is seated on a beast and she is being fueled by a scarlet beast, a fierce beast. beast. And this signifies that not every ecclesiastical system in this time will be pushed by the power of God. There are some systems that will look like they are being pushed by the power of God, and yet they will have beasts behind them. They will have scarlet beasts and influences behind them. But in this time, when John was isolated, when you and I have been isolated, the Spirit of God, because he said, and the Spirit carried me, the Spirit of God will cause you to be able to discern what to hear, who to hear it from, where to take it, where to receive it. Because as much as there is a church, there is also a scarlet beast. As much as there is a godly fellowship, there is also false prophecy. And we cannot run away from that. As much as there is something that is godly, these are the times when people will be drawn away by what is vain and ungodly, by what is not orchestrated by God. These are the times when the fake will look like it is true. Because if the church is a woman, and what you want to see is a woman, if you are not in the spirit, you will see a woman. But it takes more than just your eyes to be able to see the beast. And John the Revelator was in the spirit on that day, and he was able to see that yes, there are some ecclesiastical systems that are going to be lifted up by the Spirit of God, but there are some ecclesiastical systems that are going to be pushed, oh come on, by beasts, oh by what is evil, and they will take whatever jumps on them with them. Oh my brother, my sister, may the Spirit of the Lord open your eyes today in this time of isolation, so that like John the Revelator, God will avail your eyes not only to see what is beautiful, but also to see what is of God, not only to see what is wealthy, but only to also to see what is holy, not only to see what is physical, not only to see what is encouraging, but also to avoid what will kill you. Oh, and God opened John the Revelator's eyes, and there was a beautiful woman, but under her there was a beast propelling her, driving her, taking her. Oh, somebody, may God open your spiritual eyes. May God give you understanding in these times. Yes, may God give you understanding in these times. I know that that is a controversial topic, but if we are talking about the end time anointing, we cannot avoid this. And these are the reasons why we are spirit filled, so that we will stand up with our mouths and cast that beast and say to the woman, you are being fueled by a beast. You may have started well, you may have been on course, but right now that is not the power of the Spirit of God. In fact, the power of God is showing us that there is a beast fuel in you. Oh, come on somebody. God is dressing you with the anointing to see the fuel behind the power. Oh, the movement behind what is seen. God carried John the Revelator, and he was able to see. Oh, come on somebody. Say, I'm going to see it. I'm going to discern it. Oh, come on somebody. Oh, come on around somebody, people are not going to be simply trapped into the demonic. They will be confessed into it. People are not going to be to have ropes pulled on their neck and drawn near to the Antichrist. They will be convinced that that is not the Antichrist. Yes, and that is why in this time, let us pray that in this time of isolation, in this time of physical imprisonment, that God will open our eyes like John the Revelator to see the fuel behind every ecclesiastical system, and to be able to rebuke the beast, because John the Revelator causes us to realize that the beast himself will not show himself as a beast, but he will hide under a system. He will hide under a system, and it will be very difficult to discern. But John the Revelator said, I was led in the spirit. When you have the oil, you will see the fuel behind the system. You will see the beast behind the system. You will see the Antichrist behind the system. Because if he comes as horns, if he comes as nails, you will not be able to see him. I know that there are people who will rubbish this word. I know that there are people who will fight this word. But if it is yours, receive it. There is a system that you must discern. There is a fellowship that you must discern. People are going to be dragged into the wrong things, because this is the final hour. Oh my God. John the Revelator says, I was in the spirit. Come on, continue to say, I was in the spirit on the day of our Lord. So he was not just old. He was not just old by the beautiful woman, but the Spirit of the Lord showed him what was driving that beautiful woman, what was driving that ecclesiastical church, ecclesiastical system, what was driving that movement. And he saw it because he was in the spirit. In this time, may God open our eyes so that we are not dragged down, because we are the city on top of the hill. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Revelation chapter 4 verse 2. Because of time, I may have to stop here. But I will read Revelation chapter 4 verse 2 to you. Immediately, I was in the spirit, and behold, a throne was standing in heaven, and one sitting on the throne. Behold, a throne was standing in heaven. He is in prison. He is in exile. But he says, God showed me that he was still on the throne, and his throne in heaven had not been taken over. Actually, the throne was standing. Hallelujah.
Amen.
My final encouragement to you tonight is, despite the pain, despite the worry, despite the confusion in your life, the throne of God is still standing in heaven. It may look like the devil has gotten a foothold on this world through the economics, through the recession, through the coronavirus. But if you could look up in heaven, his throne is still standing, and there is one who is seated on the throne. Oh, come on, somebody, I exalt you, Lord. Your throne still stands. and someone is still seated. Regardless of what has happened to your family, oh, the throne is set in heaven. Oh, come on, somebody. And the throne still stands, and our God is seated on it. Regardless of the pain and the worry, regardless of the fear, regardless of the facts that we don't know when this will end, I want you to know that the heavens are open and the throne is still standing. Our God is still God. Our Lord is sovereign. He is still the King of Kings. He is still the Lord of Lords. Hey, hallelujah. He is reigning over the coronavirus. He is reigning over our worry. He is wearing over the economic recession. May God show you that the throne is still standing. His throne is still standing. The Spirit of God, the Spirit of God, took John the Revelator to heaven, and he saw that in heaven God was still in control, and things begin in heaven and they happen on earth as well. God is in control in heaven, and therefore he is on control in us. And whatever we bind on earth will be bound in heaven, but whatever we loose on earth will be loosed in heaven, because in heaven, oh, come on somebody, he's still on the throne in heaven. He still reigns. You may have cried today, you may have felt lonely today, you may have been separated like John the Revelator today, you may have been abandoned like John the Revelator today, but in heaven he's still on the front. He is still sovereign. He is still God. He is still the King of Kings. He is still the Lord of Lords. He is still El Shaddai. Oh, our God is in control. He's reigning over corona. He's reigning over lack of funds. He's reigning over uncertainty. He's reigning over our worry. He's reigning over our tears. Oh, may the Spirit of God carry you like he did John the Revelator, to see that our God still reigns. Therefore tonight, your mindset is changing. Every spirit of depression has left. Oh, every spirit of mourning is leaving. Our God reigns. He is reigning. Take your eyes off the four rooms that you were locked in. Take your eyes off the island of Botimas. Lift them up. Stand on the highest mountain. Peep into heaven and say, he reigns. He reigns. Even though I'm not working, he reigns. Even though I'm believing God for food, he reigns. Even though I'm feeling unwell, he reigns. Even though I don't know what to do, he reigns. Even though I don't know where to go, he reigns. Even though I don't know when this is coming to an end, oh my God reigns. He reigns. And because he's still reigning in heaven, he's reigning in your room. He's reigning in your house. He's reigning among my children. He's reigning in my marriage. He's reigning in my ministry. He's reigning in my health. Oh, Jedidah, your God is reigning. Tracy Gambe, he's reigning. Aine Mbabazi, he's reigning. Oh, Harriet, he's reigning. Zion, he's reigning. Rose, he's reigning. Goretti, a team, he reigneth. Oh, Mugenye, he reigneth. He's reigning. Monica, he reigns. Alan of Air, he reigns. Gary Linja, Messera, he reigns. Joan Bless, he reigns. Our God reigns. Oh, Revelations 4 verse 2. Immediately I was in the spirit, and behold, a throne was standing in heaven. Oh, come on. His throne still stands. Corona has not thrown it down. Confusion has not thrown it down. Your worry has not thrown it down. Your lack has not thrown it down. Your disease has not thrown it down. John the Revelator's abandonment
had not thrown down the throne. He still reigns. And because he reigns in heaven, he reigns in our houses. He reigns in our homes. He reigns among our children. He reigns in our health. He reigns in our life. Oh, come on, continue to shout. Cry, he reigns. He reigns. The Spirit of the Lord, as you shout out, has opened your eyes today, and you are peeping into heaven. You have lifted your mind. Your mindset is changed. You are no longer in a place of imprisonment. You are in a place of visitation. You are in a place of embracing. You are in a place of revelation. You are in a place. Oh, you have been called. You are being lifted. Come on, somebody. Say, he reigns in my life, in my health, in everything of mine. John the Revelator peeped into heaven because of the Spirit, and he saw a reigning God, and he realized that even in this place of imprisonment, his God still reigns. Oh, my brother, my sister, even in this place, he still reigns. Even in this place, he's still God. Even in this place, he's still the King of Kings. Even in this place, every knee will still bow, every tongue will still confess. Even in this place, Josh Vincent, he reigns. Chirabo, he reigns. France, he reigns. Oh, come on, somebody, he still reigns. He still reigns. You can only see him reigning if you are in the Spirit. John the Revelator said, and I was in the Spirit on the day of our Lord. Oh, come on, someone, I feel like praising God tonight. I feel like worshiping God tonight. Oh, I want the choir to come back and sing that song, Nakola Mukama, again.
Amen.
We are going to cry out to him. We are going to say, Lord, you are worthy. We are going to say, you reign. We say, your Spirit has led us, like John the Revelator, to peep into heaven. And we can see that your throne is still standing. And you still reign. You still reign. You still reign.